Hello, ugly duckling. Like a butterfly rising from the ashes, I'm on a mission to transform you into a smartwatch. And my similes are apparently as terrible as French fries on a chalkboard. So in part one, we took you out of your shell, ripped off your face, and transplanted it onto a different brain. It's actually more PG than it sounds. And now that we have a working screen, it's time to make it act more like a smartwatch. Here's a breakdown of what we need to do. It needs to connect to a smartphone via Bluetooth, and we also want it to tell time and date, as well as light up and vibrate a motor whenever it receives a call or a text notification. Those are the basic functions, and I may add more as we go. I've gone ahead and swapped out my larger Arduino with an Arduino Mini that's more size appropriate. The LCD connections and the code should still work the same. I did end up moving the LCD's LED pin to Arduino pin 8 so that I could control it separately. The critical piece to watchifying this puzzle is Bluetooth. It's how it will communicate with your smartphone. I've opted to use this HC06 Bluetooth module. Now there are smaller ones available, but you have to excel at surface mount soldering to get them connected. And while I excel at all the things, surface mount soldering is what I excel at least. Now on to the motor. Normally to wire up a motor to an Arduino, you need a resistor, a diode, and a transistor. And if you're a stickler for wiring standards, you're free to follow that method. But since this is a very tiny motor with very little power, and I have very little space for it, I'm wiring it directly to pin 3. I apologize if that makes some of you cringe. Lastly, I have a momentary button that will be used to turn on the backlight. Now let's beef up the Arduino code. Here's our code from last time, which essentially shows a splash screen. Added a few more variables and... whoa, what type of variables are these? Alright, so if you want to display images on your LCD, then go ahead and grab some images and make sure they're black and white, open them up in a photo editor, and resize them to something smaller than 65 pixels wide by 96 pixels tall, and then save it as a bitmap file. Then you can open it up in this neat little program called LCD Assistant and export it as code to use in your Arduino program. I stored mine as a variable along with the height and width of the image. Now under the setup section, we can initiate the serial comms, assign pin values, and prep the screen. This section lights up the backlight and sends a text and image splash screen, waits 5 seconds, and then clears everything. In the loop section, it gets a little bit more complicated, but here's a quick run through. First, you can delete all this. Then we'll loop through the serial input, checking to see if anything has been sent through Bluetooth. What we're hoping to send from the Android smartphone is a string that looks like this. And each of these variables represents an element that will be displayed on the screen. So what we can do is read through this string until the first separator appears, and then store that section as a variable, and do so for each of the other elements until we reach the new line character. Now what we can do is check to see if those variables contain anything, and if they do, we can perform actions. For example, if the time hasn't changed, then nothing has been sent, and we can display an error. Otherwise, if it equals something like this, we can display that to the LCD screen. Same thing with the date. If the phone variable changes, we can display the phone icon along with the phone number that was sent. We can also set an LCD backlight timer and buzz the motor. Then once the call stops, the variable will return to normal and we can reset everything. Essentially, it's the same code for the text messages, except I buzzed the motor differently so that you can tell the difference between a call and a text. This is our code for the button that triggers the backlight, and this checks to see if the backlight variable has been triggered and sends it through a timer that tells it how long to stay on. This code definitely isn't polished and perfect, but I've made it available on GitHub so you can use it for inspiration and change it however you like. You can now upload this code to your Arduino and you should see a splash screen, but then the screen's just going to go blank. This is because it's not receiving any data. For that, we need to make a quick Android app. This is App Inventor. I use it for quickly mocking up Android apps. For this smartwatch app, I'm using a list picker for connecting to Bluetooth, a button for disconnecting it, and a couple of labels to show the connection status. It's just very basic. They're organized using a horizontal layout component, and then I added a clock timer, texting and phone call component, and a Bluetooth server component. These are the basic components that I used, but you can organize and add however many components you want. Jumping over to the programming side, I have a full write-up of each element over on the project page. So for now, I'm just going to summarize how they all work. When the phone initializes, it checks to see if Bluetooth is connected and sets the status accordingly. Before picking from the list picker, fill it with Bluetooth names and addresses, and then after picking something from the list picker, connect to the selection that was made and update the status text. Then when the disconnect button is clicked, terminate the connection and change the status text. Next, create the string variable to send to the Arduino, and then create three more variables to store the phone info. One for if it's ringing, which is true or false, one for who's calling, and one that's an iteration counter. When a phone call is started, check to see if it's incoming, and if so, store the info in these variables. Similarly, create three more variables for the text message, four if you want to store the message content itself. And whenever a text message is received, you can pass its info onto these variables. Now, this is the block that does all the work. It loops through once a second and checks for new data, appends the current time to our string variable, appends the date, checks for an incoming call, and if true, then it appends that data and sends it in a loop for 10 seconds, after which it exits the loop and resets the variable. And then it does the same thing for the incoming text. It then sends that string of information to the Arduino and resets the string to start over. Now you can download the APK or use the companion app to run it on your phone. If this is too complicated, I've uploaded mine to the Google Play App Store if you want to just download it. With the Arduino on, make sure the smartphone is paired with Arduino's Bluetooth and then launch your app and connect to it. If everything was done correctly, you should see the time and date on the screen. Pressing the button should initiate the backlight. And then if someone sends you a call or text, it should light up and show the number on the screen and vibrate the motor. If you want, there are a lot more things that you can do from here. App Inventor has a new pedometer feature that allows you to send step data to your watch. And on the Arduino side, you can add an accelerometer so that the watch itself can count your steps. You could also add a real-time clock module to keep time without having to be tethered to your phone. And there's even a heart rate monitor that you could add. But I'm just going to keep it simple for now. Next time, we'll shrink it all down, find a way to power it, and cram it all into a wrist-sized case. If you want to see more of my Smart Watch series, I've created a playlist where you can stay up to date with the videos when they become available. What ideas would you like me to cover next? Submit or vote for your favorites at tinkernut.com/ideas. Click here to watch more videos like this, and if you get any value out of my show and like to give some value back, please feel free to like, subscribe, comment, follow me on social media, or donate at tinkernut.com/donate. All right, that's it for this tutorial. For more, go to tinkernut.com.